Thank you. Original Treaty Center is one of the centers of the UNEP Mediterranean Action Plan, which works for the conservation of the marine biodiversity in the Mediterranean. So the first thing is to mention you that we work with 21 countries, all the countries surrounding the Mediterranean region. Here we are going to present the process which we have followed to work in the creation of national networks of marine protected areas. We have a very heterogeneous situation in the Mediterranean regarding the development of this issue in the countries. So we needed to boost the creation of these networks in several of the countries which were in different scales of development. Some of them have not even a marine protected area. Some of them have some protected areas but not properly managed, and the majority of them have not the system to network them. So the idea was to build in the existing network, to build the experience of the different countries, and to promote the change among all of them. As we said, well, our center what does is to catalyze and to support the national institutions to develop these activities. So one of the objectives was to boost the creation of seven new marine protected areas in different countries around the Mediterranean. As an example, we have areas created in... Is this pointer here?
Yes.
For example, we work for protected areas in Albania, in Montenegro, Morocco, Algeria, Libya, to give you examples of the different kind of countries that we were working with. As we said, in many cases we had to work with the development of several priority areas that were needed for the creation of marine protected areas in these countries. And one of the key ones was to identify the stakeholder groups and the potential partnership that each country could develop in order to accelerate this process. So that was done, for example, in Albania, in Croatia, Libya, Montenegro, and Morocco. At the same time, we needed to do real biological research, surveys in the areas to know what we need to protect. In some cases, some countries, we didn't know about the marine environment. Very simple. So, for example, we work in 14 potential sites in countries like Croatia, Lebanon, and Montenegro, from sending divers and scientific staff to the countries to work with local staff in order to find what is underwater. Then also we had to work very much in the technical assistance and the capacity building to improve this network. So we work very much the issue of training. We did 29 training events which achieved the training of more than 200 participants from scientific diving to stakeholder exchange to outreach of the results of work, every kind of levels of work. That included also, very important, it was the on-job training during the field survey. So since we had to go with international teams to work in surveying and monitoring of biodiversity in areas, we profit to bring local scientists or graduates for university in order to really do a training on work and on how these data are collected. And many times it's not gotten in several universities. It's not easy to have this field training in the sea. So we did also training sessions regarding monitoring, how the process of an MPA creation and management should go. And also we prepared teaching package and guidelines and tools. So we published several documents on that. And then one of the important parts was to disseminate the project results and communicate all the achievements. And we work also to promote that at national level. So we did meetings, discussion, work with local stakeholders, including diving clubs, fishermen, notably fishermen. We work very much in collaboration with the FAO and UCN. We did a set of collaborations on that. And the question was to raise the value of the MPAs, to sensitize public, because it's not only important to do the work at the country level with the local, let's say, national experts, but also to create, let's say, like a market of interest in the general public. So, well, just will show one of the several examples that we have, for example, in the creation of networks of MPAs for Lebanon. We started having a vision developed by the country stakeholders, so what they wanted. So they wanted an effective marine protected network that could sustain the development, but enhancing the values of nature and culture. So with this vision, they developed the activities. They work in the definition of the possible network, in the mapping on the through surveys and work. And then they set the concrete objective that was, of course, preserve biodiversity and the resources, and they address the management of the natural resources. So to keep always a balance between conservation and human use. Let's not forget the Mediterranean has been inhabited by thousands of years. There is a very strong human presence. These are not pristine areas like in some other parts of the world. So we have to really start with this basis and work in the situation that we have. So there was a scientific assessment of the values, also the socioeconomic part, as we said, that we had to consider. And then we did a strong work in interviewing and having exchange with local stakeholders to really work for what they really want. Otherwise, we cannot just come and impose a protected area. So as we said, we did the same process like in other areas, an ecological characterization of the coast of the country and the marine part. Then evaluate these areas, including human impact. And then to see which are the more adequate ones to be protected, including a proposal of management recommendations and zoning proposals. An ideal network of MPAs usually is not a real one. We said scientifically what would be an ideal network, but then there are the different economic and human constraints, so we had to keep a balance and select. Okay, so for every country where we were working with the authorities and the stakeholders, we extracted the key lessons and recommendations for the follow-up. Let's not forget that our institutions or regional centers do the catalyst job. It's a mission, of course, of the country to continue working. We try to boost and to accelerate the issues, but it's the country's sovereign responsibility. So we extracted these key lessons that are different in the different countries. So in the case of Lebanon, it was clear that they have to continue improving the biodiversity assessment and the inventories of the different habitats for these MPAs. There is a lot of work to be done yet, but they can already work for conservation. We have to wait until having perfect scientific results. Then there is an identified need to strengthen the MPA governance system in the country. So it was decided together with them that a protected area unit at the Ministry of Environment would be needed to be created, like in a protected areas agency. Then draft the requirements for management plan and legal tests for the new MPAs, so to do a standardizing at legal and policy implementation level for the country, so they know what to do when they decide about working in a protected area. And of course, always the capacity building has to go on, including the training and exchange of visits to other parts in other regions. We did also, there are parallel regional actions that I will not mention here, but we did regional actions like putting together all these stakeholders coming to another country where these networks and to exchange experience. Then another important part was a workforce establishing sustainable finance mechanisms that has to be worked very much at the internal level of the country. And then to increase the public awareness and the education on the values of MPAs, to have the real public support to continue with these actions. So we will stay here just to remark that it's a key issue to keep in touch and involve all the relevant stakeholders in the setting of MPAs, especially to do it from the very beginning. There are other areas, I will not stay, but you can see areas like in Libya, we did a similar process. Even you know, before the challenging situation we have, we advanced a lot, and we can say that even you know Libya is facing difficulties now, but we still keep good exchange and even involving Libyan authorities when we do in other foreign countries activities. They come and we still can keep, even in when difficult situations, we can keep alive the processes in the country for the situation when the things we can samples like in Morocco with the network also, and the specific works done with the surveys, and an equivalent issue, for example, for Montenegro, the setting of the definition of the areas, and so on. Okay, thank you.
Thanks very much. Thank you.